Thank you all for coming and welcome. We really, really appreciate your patience. We didn't expect to have such a great response to this event, so we booked a theater that was smaller than we should have, but thank you for helping us accommodate everyone else in the other theater. My name is Gwyneth Dolan, and I'm the moderator today. I'd like to introduce our debaters. We have Senator Sue Wilson-Beffert of Sandia Park. Representative Brian Egolf of Santa Fe. Representative Dennis Kintai of Roswell. Keep it down. And Representative Janice Arnold-Jones of Albuquerque. The purpose of this event is to have a thoughtful and interactive discussion of how we deal with film policy in New Mexico. And it's interactive. You've all got index cards that you've been handed out, and we have collected a bunch of your questions already. Please write them down, borrow a pen, ask your neighbor. And Lynette over there in the white shirt has the fishbowl for your questions, and we'll be choosing some of them for the second part of the debate. I would like to introduce you now to Paul Gessing of the Rio Grande Foundation and Eric Witt of the New Mexico Motion Picture Association, who are the sponsors of today's debate.
Thanks, Gwyneth. The Rio Grande Foundation is New Mexico's only fiscally conservative think tank. Decades of experience have shown economists that fair, low, and simple taxes are most effective in driving economic growth. Unfortunately, New Mexico's film subsidies violate this fairness principle. Under the program, tax dollars are taken from single moms trying to get their kids into better schools and small businessmen who are attempting to get their companies off the ground. Those tax dollars are then given directly to one favorite industry, the film industry. This is not only unfair, but in my view, it is both poor economics and morally dubious. While the Rio Grande Foundation has always had concerns about the film program, the state's $400 million deficit and the need to balance the budget gives the issue an urgency it has previously not had. Thank you for coming, and I look forward to an enlightening and vigorous debate on the issue. Thank you.
I've been called morally dubious by better people than that. The film industry has, without question, been the single most successful economic development jobs creation effort in the state in recent years, if not decades. We didn't choose this business because we like making movies. We chose it because it has the effect that you see here today. Thousands of people working in this business, helping those small startup businesses get up and running. Paul and I have a lot more in common than you may think. I am very fiscally conservative myself. I come out of an MBA background. I'm a finance guy. This business works for New Mexico, bottom line. You get more money in than you pay out. Were you to eliminate the industry, you wouldn't have as much money. For we talk about the deficit. Guess what? You'd have less money to spend. Less money to spend on child care. So I agree that we need to be fiscally responsible, and I look forward to the debate. Thank all the debaters for being here.
I'm hearing from you that there are some supporters in the audience. I'd like to ask you to help me out here, and please keep your applause and cheers to a minimum, no matter what side you're on. We started really late, and we want to get through as many questions as possible and as many of your questions as possible. And we want to make sure that this is an environment where everybody feels good being heard and that we're all listening and not spending all our time clapping. So please help me keep it down, and please be respectful, everyone, and we will get into this discussion. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the ground rules. The way that we've got this organized, I'll ask a question, and we've drawn a lottery. We have an order that the questions will be posed in, and then I'll allow 30 seconds for everyone else to respond if they choose. And then we'll move on to the next question. We'll do that for about 30 minutes. And then we will ask some of your questions from the fishbowl for about 15 minutes. So I want to keep us on that schedule as much as possible. So let's start with the first question. And this is an easy one. This is going to be for you, Representative Kintai. Why should we give the... Oh, opening statements. I'm sorry, you're right. We're going to do opening statements first, and we'll go in this order. So, Representative Kintai, you have 1 minute for your opening statement here. Sorry, thank you.
Thank you, Gwyneth. Thank you for this. Thank you, Doug, Eric, Paul, for putting it on. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for participating, folks out there in the audience. I'm Dennis Kintai. I'm the bad guy in this movie.
That's right.
The villain, the Darth Vader, if you will. I'm the guy who asks questions that are not supposed to be asked. But that's what I've done for a long time. I ask questions, I ask hard ones, because that's how you get to the truth. Truth that might not be popular, might not be pleasant, but it's truth. The truth of the matter is, this is bad economic policy. This hurts the citizens of New Mexico. And I've been on a crusade for a couple years now to try and get that message out, because I believe fundamentally this is wrong. The facts are there to show it. Hopefully tonight you'll hear some facts. Thank you for putting this on.
And now for an opening statement, Senator Beffert.
Thank you. And thank everyone in the audience for your interest in this issue. And I consider this upcoming session probably the most serious that we have had, even though we've had other budget years. Thank you for putting this on top of my notes. But I just want to say, many of you know that I'm a former business person. I like all the other tax credits. I like all the other rebates and things. This is the only industry that's being targeted right now, and this has the largest sustained growth since our recession hit. So, it's a very, very intricate web that we have, and when you say tighten up or just lower a little bit, there are unintended consequences, and I would be interested in talking about that this afternoon. Thank you. Yes.
Representative Arnold Jones.
You can yell at me and throw everything. I don't have a vote this coming session, so let's have a discussion. You know, from a tax policy perspective, this is terrible policy. However, it is not irrecoverable. I have always thought that the definitions were way too narrow. The media is expanding exponentially. And unfortunately, we've kind of limited some pieces of it. Now, as a business manager myself, the 25% credit against expenses, there are no taxes involved, a little hard to swallow. So is there some middle ground? I think there is. I absolutely think, and you're looking at me like there are no taxes, there are no taxes involved. It is a credit against expenses. And that is where the tax policy really gets to be a problem. So let's see if we can find some middle ground that sustains an industry. I'd like to see a really strong production model.
Thank you. Representative Eagle.
Thanks. Thank you to the sponsors. I'm happy to be here. New Mexico is blessed, and truly this economy blessed, to have a vibrant industry that is creating great, good-paying jobs that cannot be outsourced and that are clean. And this program is the envy of dozens of our sister states. We're going to hear a lot of attacks tonight, this afternoon, against the film program. The attacks are really based in ignorance. People that don't understand what this program is, what it was meant for, how it works, or what it does and the effect it has in every community in the state. Instead of looking at this program, instead of looking at all the other programs that send $400 million to dirty industries, including oil and gas, potash and coal, this industry has been targeted unfairly and the arguments that have been made in terms of auditing and other things are completely out of line and out of place, because this is the only incentive program in the history of the state of New Mexico that has been repeatedly audited and shown to have created jobs and made money for New Mexico. This is the only one. To kill it now is short-sighted and bad policy.
Now we will start with the first question to Representative Kinzai. Sorry for the false start.
Okay.
So, as some of you mentioned in your opening statements, the film program has extensive reporting requirements, and every film that receives the rebates is audited. Do you think that if we're going to do this for the film industry, should we increase the reporting requirements for other industries that receive credits and rebates? Should we expand the reporting and accountability across industries?
Well, Gwyneth, I'll disagree with your first base point there. The audits that you're talking about don't exist. In 2009, when I sent letters to Tax and Revenue asking for specific information on the payments to the various film industries, I was told I could not have access to the claims that were submitted because they were considered taxpayer ID. The only thing that the Tax and Revenue Department would provide to me was a listing. Over a time period, there were 72 different payments made. 72 payments, the date of the check, and the amount of the check. That is the only information that would release to me. I then went to the PRC website. One third of those companies that received checks in the rebate program were not listed on the PRC website. One third were out-of-state corporations. Only one third were New Mexico companies. We don't know where this money is going. It's shrouded in secrecy. So first, we need to open this up for transparency.
Thank you. Senator Beffert, you have 30 seconds to respond, and then each of the rest of you will have 30 seconds.
Well, I guess I certainly understand that we want accountability and transparency and so on, but I go back to the issue of the over a billion other tax rebates and other issues that we deal with other industries. And right now, what I'm dealing with in Santa Fe as a Finance Committee member is 89,000 unemployed people. Mm-hmm. And so my time is up. I'm saying that this is our bright star, and it worries me that we would juggle it and possibly change it. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you. Now we go to Representative Arnold Jones. 30 seconds.
We're talking about the credits against expenses and the auditing requirements. Representative Kintai is correct. You cannot see those audits. However, increasing more audits, you know, increasing the bureaucracy is not going to help us. What we have to do is simplify the process. So if we were actually talking about a tax that could be audited, you could actually simplify the amount of resources spent by each film production entity significantly. Simplify, simplify.
Thank you. Representative Egolf, 30 seconds.
Bring more accountability to oil, gas, coal, and potash, absolutely. How can we be giving away $400 million a year? And many of these tax loopholes that have been placed in our tax code by special interest lobbyists, many of these are exemptions from the gross receipts tax. What that means is that unlike deductions, where the income is reported and then you deduct it from the total before you pay the tax, these exemptions are never even reported in the first place. And this has been going on for decades in favored industries. And if you want to talk about a favored industry, according to most in the state legislature over the last decades, certainly hasn't been film. It's been oil, gas, and the other industries that have gotten $400 million in giveaways of your money.
Thank you. I'm going to start cutting you guys off if you go over 30 seconds. All right. The second question here will go to Senator Beffert, and we're going to continue in this order. Senator, the rebate right now is not capped. Governor Martinez has proposed capping the program. Part of the criticism of not having a cap is that we don't know exactly how much we're going to refund from year to year. Should we cap the program? You have 1 minute.
It's my recollection that California put a cap on their program, and what that means is that you have the different companies that come and get in line, and you approve a couple because it approaches the cap. All the others, fortunately for us, left the state and came here and to other wonderful states. So I go back to the issue of here we are trying to climb out of this recession, and this is not the proper time to start saying let's cap or let's lower the percentage. By the way, New Mexico is only ninth in line in terms of the handsome nature of our film industry. I think that we are blessed to have the wonderful movies that excites me every time I see, and my wrap-up card is here. But capping, I think, would be even more injurious to the industry than any other type of adjustment.
Thank you. Representative Arnold Jones, you have 30 seconds.
I don't like the first come, first serve aspect of it because it really cuts out New Mexico filmmakers. I don't like that part. The other side is the mantra will be, we need to put money into education. Where is the money going to come from? And so at some point you have to have a very realistic view of your budget. And I'm hesitant to say put a cap on it, but if it means pulling $50 million out of education, what do you choose?
Representative Eagle.
Over the history of the film program, the Tax and Revenue Department has been incredibly precise in the estimates of what the film rebate is going to cost, within $1 million or so each year. So we're already at a predictable level in terms of knowing what we're going to be spending in the year ahead. So there's not a problem of uncertainty. In fact, a year ago they were within $500,000. But more importantly, and this is a decision that would be made by any business, if you have a growing profit center that is producing results for your company, why would you limit it?
Thank you.
It doesn't make any sense.
Thank you.
We're going to move on. Help me move this along smoothly. Representative Kintai, 30 seconds.
My understanding is the governor is actually proposing a reduction of percentage of the cap. And the problem with the cap is, as everyone has mentioned here, it's brought on because, I'll disagree with Representative Egoff, LFC has not been able to predict what it would go to. We don't know how much we're going to spend from year to year. It fluctuates. It's gone from 47 to 75 to 62. Cap is better than nothing, but we are pouring money. We are bleeding money. We've got to stop it.
Thank you. We're going to move on to the next question. And this will go to Representative Arnold Jones. If 20 other states have programs, 29, we have some debates over whose programs are more generous than ours, but if other states have programs that are more generous than ours and we're still attracting business, why should we not cut it a little bit?
That's kind of an interesting way to ask that question. You know, if 20 other states have a program like this, and I will tell you, I argued this the time it came up in 2003, there comes a point at which you cannot sell off of the rate card. And that is the race that you are proposing, is keeping up with all of the other states. At some point, we have to sell the value in the state of New Mexico and not worry what everybody else is doing. I have so much faith in the talent in this state that I don't care if Wisconsin gives 40%. We have a better film climate, and that's what we have to sell. And we will still get the jobs.
Thank you. Representative Eagle, you have 30 seconds.
The reason we don't want to cut is the people in this room and the 12,000 other people that are dependent upon this industry for their jobs and their mortgage payments and their car payments. Yeah. Movies, contrary to public, to widespread belief, are operating on very slim profit margins. So the amount of the rebate is huge, but also we've got the base. We've spent a decade investing in the post-production, in the people behind the camera, all those kids going to high school to learn how to work in this industry, they're
right
here. And that is a huge benefit for us, but it also depends on the financing decisions that these studios make. That's why we need to keep the rebate exactly as it is.
Thank you. Representative Kintai?
I believe it's time to start reevaluating. Other states are doing it. Kansas, Iowa, New Jersey have all suspended their program. Rhode Island has capped it, and Arizona has let their program expire. It's time to do more than just suspend it. We need to cap it.
Thank you. Representative Egolf, I know you took your glasses off, but there are two ladies sitting up here with little cards. And they indicate when your time is running now, right?
That's why I took my glasses off.
May I suggest you put them back on? So, next question, and this one is... Oh, I'm sorry, Senator. Forgive me.
Women have to speak up. Yes. You know, I want to go back to the original premise of cost versus expenditure. If we gave $135 million worth of tax credits, that means that our budget got $504 million for education and fortunately so that we don't have more unemployed people that
right.
are sitting with no jobs. So, you know, it's all relative when you talk about a program and what the costs are.
Yeah.
Now for the next question. This one will go to Representative Arnold Jones first. Did I ask you first last time? All right, Representative Eagle first then. We have a serious budget deficit in the state, and we know that we have to make cuts coming into the next legislative session. If we don't cut this program, where would you suggest we cut?
Well, that's pretty easy. I would propose that we make an across-the-board 1% cut in the overall gross receipts tax for every New Mexican and pay for it by a reduction of 80% of all of the loopholes and tax credits and exemptions and deductions that go to the industries of the past that no longer need a subsidy. And I mentioned those industries already. That's one. Two, we can... I disagree with the premise that we need to have further and deeper cuts. There are some places that we can save. We've already cut $800 million out of the state budget over the last 2 years. People seem to forget that. We have fewer state employees now than when Bill Richardson took office. We are a much smaller state government, and there are some common sense measures like making Best Buy and Walmart pay New Mexico's corporate tax, just like a Mexico-based company. That would raise $90 million. Charging a dime a drink would raise another $90 million. And between those three measures, not only do we close a budget deficit, we give a huge tax cut to everybody who lives in the state of New Mexico. Yeah.
Thank you. Representative, you have 30 seconds.
Where do we cut? There aren't many places left, though. Representative Egoff is correct. We have cut many, many programs. We have furloughed employees. We have raised taxes. We have reduce the take-home pay of teachers, and this program has been cut a bit. Everyone needs to take a penalty or to share in the pain, and this industry is privileged. Not only does it not suffer any reduction, it gets subsidized.
Thank you. Senator Becker?
Thank you. You know, every major economic expert in the United States says that you never cut or raise taxes in a recession. What a lot of people are not aware of is that businesses exist so that they can hire people, add jobs, things of that nature. We can still cut our overhead. We've never had any systemic recurring cuts in our government. So business and pay taxes, and we have to be very careful about monkeying around with the tax for business.
Thank you. Representative Arnold Jones.
It's kind of scary, Brian. I think we might agree. And here's the problem. You know, our tax code is just, it looks like Swiss cheese. It is time to pull back all of the incentives, reduce the gross receipts tax, and then very selectively, marginally target what we're doing so that we have some bona fide results. Everybody wins, including every single small business owner in here.
Thank you. Moving on. There's been some reference to a tax expenditure budget, which is a list of tax credits and rebate programs in New Mexico. We do not currently have this in New Mexico. So the next question, which goes to Representative Kintai first, is would you support a tax expenditure budget? Did I miss?
Representative,
you go. No, he started.
We're just messing
you
up here.
This is the fifth question.
I think we're good.
Okay. I don't know what you mean by a tax expenditure budget.
a list of these kind of credits and programs across industries for the whole state?
We have had that presentation, and Tax and Revenue made the presentation on that in Cloud Crop in 2009, if I remember right. And they listed, and it's been in other LFC meetings where there's been lists of the different subsidy tax credits that have been in effect, and this is by far the largest. The other one, next largest, I believe, or maybe the largest, is the not taxing food. That's the largest. But that documentation's been out there for at least 2 years that I know. So we should look at all of them. Yes.
Senator Beffert.
I go back to saying, can the whole state and all of the industries look at a review down the line? I say that that's always a fair question. Right now, we are trying to recover from the worst recession that we have had in certainly my time here. This is not the time to target the gold standard film program in the United States. So down the line, that would be something that would be a good procedure.
Thank you, Representative Arnold Jones.
For all businesses, predictability is really important. I looked at the tax expenditure report. It's 29 pages. Do you think we might have a lot of credits? I can only imagine how much money you're spending chasing the credits, keeping track of what you're doing. Simplification would actually help us sustain this business rather than you chasing the actual accounting costs in each production.
Thank you. Representative Eagle.
I do support a tax expenditure budget. Because I think that when you put the film program up against any other tax incentive, it wins against anyone else every day of the week, no matter what. But it's going to bring a new level of accountability and transparency to the $1.25 billion of other tax credits and incentives that the state pursues, so that we really know what we're talking about. It's critical to know where we are, what we're spending our money on, and that's a good first step.
Thank you. I think we're ready for the next question. Senator Beffert, this goes to you. The incentives do cost us money, and times are tough. So if we were not to spend this money on the film incentive program, what else could we do to promote a sustainable film industry in New Mexico?
Tell me. Like I said earlier, decisions are made because of finances. We don't have the highest credit, nor do we have any of the other mitigating issues that are a lot higher than other states. Companies select states based on the finances. And so why, at the heart of our recession, do we want to in any way tamper with this? It's beyond me. And I'd like to say about budgets, we're only looking at the beginning of budgets, this current budget that was put out by our new governor. It's strictly a starting point. So I'm very optimistic that this is going to be an industry that's going to be proven to be the most handsome expenditure that we have with our tax credits.
Thank you. What could we do to promote the industry that doesn't cost money?
You know, it's a really tough one because we have provided schools training, we have provided free equipment, we've provided free locations, we've provided free money and a 25% credit against expenses. There are not too many other places to go. That being said, the one place that I would look if I was going to expand any place is access to New Mexico filmmakers who are being bypassed.
Thank you. Representative Eagle.
I disagree with the premise of the question. It assumes that this costs money, that it's a loser for the state. The state of New Mexico has a net gain as a result of this program. So why would we stop it? Why would we change it? It's working perfectly. And And the premise is flawed. The only study that has looked at the New Mexico program based on New Mexico data, top to bottom, soup to nuts, concluded we make $1.50 for every dollar invested in this program. So I just disagree with the premise of the question.
Representative Kintyre.
Thank you. It's a fundamentally profound question. Janice Arnold-Jones here to my left just listed all the things that have been going on for years, and yet we're at this point where if we do not continue the subsidy, everyone says the industry will go away. So it's like an addiction. It's like being hooked on heroin. We have to keep increasing the dose. This is not good public policy to have an industry that dependent. That is the only way we can keep it.
Thank you. Folks, help me out and try to keep your emotional reactions for happy hour after this. You can share them liberally. Lynette, do you have questions that have been chosen? Can you walk them up so I don't have to vote? We will move on to the next question here. And this is for Representative Arnold Jones. How would you define...
Thank you.
How would you define a successful program? What proportion of revenue to cost would make it worth it for you?
You know, the way I define a successful program is not that parameter. Success to me are production companies that are so successful that they are able to provide benefits, that are able to fill their own pipelines without relying on the state. That, to me, defines success, a successful production environment. And that includes making sure that we expand that definition, not just to film, but to every form of media that is available. It is changing so rapidly, and that production environment that's where you're rooted right here in the state of New Mexico is what I consider success.
Thank you. Representative Eagle.
Well, I mean, how do you put a price on the livelihoods of 12,000 people?
Yeah.
You know, I mean, to say that, it's almost as though making 50% profit on the program isn't enough. And you want to do more than make a big profit for the state, put tens of thousands of people to work, support scores of small businesses across the state, touch every community in New Mexico. To me, that's a success. Would I still propose that we proceed if we had less profit? Absolutely. The state of New Mexico benefits in myriad ways from this program, and
that's right.
I don't know how to say it again, but we just need to keep it going because it's working.
Yeah. Thank you. Representative
Kintyre. I think the standard would be when the industry is no longer subsidized by the taxpayers. When the industry no longer reaches into the pockets of the working people and takes money out of it, put into their own businesses. Stay on your own, exist on your own, don't be dependent upon the taxpayers. That would be a success. That would be great.
Thank you. Senator Becker.
Yes, thank you. So I'd like to define success because I think that New Mexico, that has been touted as the gold standard, has proven what success is. We have a vendor infrastructure that is coveted by all the other states. We have been touted as having the best skilled crew.
Yay!
We have a business base that now understands films, and I could go on. Thank you.
Thank you. Lynette, I think we're going to have time for more questions from the audience. So if Paul and Eric want to choose three more and filter them up here, I think we'll be able to get to them. But I'm going to move on to one of those now. And this question will go to Representative Kintyre? No, Eagle. I think we're in order. There have been problems with film programs in other states. How does New Mexico protect itself from those pitfalls?
Well, I think Mexico has protected itself from those pitfalls. We've got a situation that's set up, it's actually pretty ingenious, where the audits that are done, and Representative Kintyre, they are done, the audits are done by the Taxation and Revenue Department, not by the Film Office. So you have a Department of Government that has an incentive to minimize the amount paid on the applications, and you don't have a film office that might see the productions as clients trying to maximize the rebate. So that's the first thing that's important. Secondly is the audits themselves. They are incredibly detailed, and they are done in such a way so that you are certain that the rebates are paid based on expenditures made to New Mexico companies, so that the New Mexico economy benefits directly, and so that New Mexico dollars stay right here in New Mexico.
Yes.
Lou Wallace, a territorial governor, said that every calculation based on experience elsewhere fails in New Mexico. This is an instance in which the opposite is true, because New Mexico has figured this out, and every other state is trying to figure it out. They haven't been able
Thank
to do
you.
It yet, and I hope they won't.
Representative Kim Tai, you have 30 seconds.
Sorry, I was distracted there. Still learning my phone. Iowa had an audit done that showed tremendous abuse. Those audits were kept concealed from the public until it was done by the state audit. I cannot get access as a state legislator to what was done. There are people in this room who know about supposed New Mexico residents who have gotten counted in those, shall we say, in-state resident rebates. Excuse me. That's happened. We've heard about it. Too many of you have come out and reached out to me in private.
Thank
There's
you.
Abuse.
Thank you. We'll move on now to Senator Becker.
And so we've had some pitfalls that we've tightened up. For instance, in 2005, we passed legislation that tightened up eligibility. There were issues that surfaced. I like the fact that you do not get your rebate until you produce your receipts. So I feel that that is an incredible standard. The audits are done by our tax department, not by a film commission itself. So this is an outside secondary protection for our citizens.
Thank you. Representative Arnold Jones.
I have to echo what Representative Kentai says. The number of calls that I've had from New Mexicans who lost out because another transplant with a P.O. box was selected over them and being reported as a New Mexican. And, you know, the more complicated we make it, the easier for this type of abuse to take place. So there are a number of things that we still have to do to clean it up.
Thank you. This question was written for Representative Kintai, but you'll all get a chance to respond to it. And the question is, what do you propose to replace 10,000 jobs and 250 businesses when the film industry evaporates in New Mexico? You have 1 minute.
That's an interesting question.
Yeah.
After $135,000, $135 million over the last 2 years, we are told that if we don't continue this subsidy, those jobs will go away. If we'd spent that $135 million on road construction, we would have had 10,000 jobs. And at the end, we would still have roads. We will have nothing if the industry leaves. As far as the 10,000 jobs, I'd like to draw your attention briefly to the Albuquerque Journal. When the Albuquerque studio was being going into foreclosure, if you look in the sidebar, it lists the number of employees as 12. The 12,000 number and the thousands of numbers being thrown around are not supported in any economic study. No, anecdotally, and advocates for this industry, but the neutral economic observers say that this data does not exist.
Thank you. And Senator Becker, you have 30 seconds.
So 10,000 jobs would be a real difficult challenge after we have 89,000 unemployed currently.
Yeah.
We know for a fact, an audible fact, that there are 2,000 or over 2,000, I've heard it's 3,000 direct jobs in this last year, supply chain jobs over 3,000. That doesn't count travel agencies that have over 30% of their business with this industry. It doesn't count hotels, other things that are indirect, and I think it would be a sad day for that to happen.
That's right.
Thank you. Representative
Arnold Jones, did I start with you, or is it your...
I got a point.
Good.
Thank you.
You know, I have to quote my friend Eric Witt, and he was on KOB reminding us that there are about 3,000 jobs. And so this number, 10,000, let's be real. But what bothers me, and let's get back to kind of the fairness of what's happening. The number of individuals who then, when they finish a project, go to unemployment is a little frightening. And so for me, success, again, is sustained employment with benefits. And that 10,000 number just doesn't cut it, doesn't get there.
Thank you, Representative Eagle.
Well, I'm sure everybody noticed what we heard an answer from the opponents, which was nothing. There's a demonstration of a lack of understanding about how employment
That's
in the industry
right.
works. It is not a 9-to-5 job. It
yes.
is temporary or seasonal. It's going production to production with intervals of unemployment in between. That's how it is everywhere, not just in New Mexico. And the idea of that these jobs could be replaced in this recession is just out there. There's no way to do it.
Thank you. All right, we've got two questions left, and we're going to move through these, and then we'll do some closing statements. This one, we'll start with you, Senator Biffert. Shouldn't economic development incentives be used to stimulate emerging high-growth industries rather than flat or sunset industries like film location production? You have a minute?
Well, naturally, if New Mexico was operating in a vacuum, I guess that would be the perfect answer. But we are not. And just like other high-tech industries and other industries, these companies go to the states they feel have the best financial outlook for them. And I go back to saying that movies are selected and advertisements and so on, not because we have beautiful mountains, because it's done on sound stages. All states have the same amenities. I go back to saying this is not as simple as just saying if we do X or we do Y, everything will be fine, because predictions of that nature, I think, are naive.
Thank you. Representative Arnold Jones.
Well, the economic development track record is not particularly good in our state. We have a number of high-tech companies that have located at Mesa Del Sol. They're not there anymore. And so is this as worthy an industry as any other one? You bet it is. But again, I'm going to go back to that model. How much and for how long should your industry be sustained by the taxpayer? You know, I go to McDonald's, I pay a buck for a cup of coffee. This industry pays 75 cents. We got to find the middle road.
Thank you. Representative Eagle.
Absolutely. I agree that the state should be supporting innovative industries and not supporting stale old ones, which is why we should stop giving away $400 million every year to old industries that don't need it, and why we should keep continuing to support a growing, vibrant, gold standard industry right here in New Mexico, the film business. I mean, that's a very simple answer, I think.
Thank you.
Thank you. I believe economic development can only come when you have litigation reform, regulation reform, budget tax reform, and infrastructure reform. You do not get any economic development by spreading tax dollars around like Tinkerbell spitting pixie dust. We have done too much of that, and it's all gone for nothing. Eclipse Aviation, Green 2B, the list goes on and on. We can't do that. We cannot waste any more taxpayer money.
Thank you.
Excuse me?
And
my job isn't a waste.
Ma'am.
It's not.
The last question we have here will go to Representative Arnold Jones, I think. Am I off? Let's go with it. The money to make movies, i.e. to pay employees and vendors, comes from outside the state. Even were New Mexico to rebate 30 cents of every dollar, doesn't the state benefit from the 70 cents left behind, which goes for gas, mortgages, clothes, goods, and services, all of which are taxed? You have 1 minute.
Yeah.
You know, anytime you have economic activity, it's a good thing. And if we have such robust activity, you have to then ask, why do we need such a subsidy? And that becomes that chicken and egg theory. And so we're really debating at what level are we going to do this. Do we benefit when the money comes from outside the state? Of course we do. Do I think it's going to completely dry up and blow away? I don't, because the people in this room are creating a vibrant community, and the reason that people are going to come here has everything to do with your talent and much less to do with some of the money that we're offering. And I want to go back to one of the film loan programs that we have. Has anybody in this room actually been able to get one of the film loans? You see, that really bothers me. It really bothers me. And so there's some structural things that we still need to do. And so it's not just about the rebate. It's about the whole program.
No, but some of us
thank
have
you.
Worked on film.
Representative Eagle.
Well, I think the answer to the question is yes.
Yes.
Right? These are out-of-state dollars flowing into New Mexico. It is a net gain. The rebate program that we have in place is modest in comparison to other states. It's supported by an enormous infrastructure that works well and is successful. All these out-of-state dollars staying in New Mexico are a benefit. So I suppose if the premise of the question is accepted, then the answer would be yes, but I think 25% is perfectly adequate.
Thank you. Representative Kintai.
This is a fundamental example of the problem with this debate. Economic activity is not the same as tax dollars. We're taking money out of the public treasury to subsidize an industry and trying to equate them. They are not the same. Because people come in here and spend some money doesn't mean that the money gets back to the treasury. In fact, analysis after analysis after analysis by solid economists all over the U.S. show the tax base does not get enriched. The tax dollars do not get back to the treasury. The treasury is poor, and so as a result, we cut services.
Thank you. We're going to move now. Senator.
I need to
stand. I'm terrible at this. Forgive me, please. 30 seconds. We'll give her 40. We'll give you a minute.
That's the question.
Kidding.
I think would be better off if we raise the subsidy. I don't think anyone's asking to raise. What I'm saying is, this is the absolute wrong time to start in any way showing any type of instability with the leading industry that we have in our state currently today.
That's right.
This is not the good time. I worry that the 119 movies that we had this last year, what would happen if we start in any way showing instability?
There'll be zero.
Thank you very much. And I thank you for your indulgence with my order of things. We're going to move to the closing statements now, and each of you will have 1 minute. We'll start with Representative Eagle, and we will move on from there.
Well, everything we hear from the opponents of the program is theoretical. When it comes to common sense air protections that go after our air, that seek to protect our air, land, and water that come up in the legislature, they're fought tooth and nail by the same crew that opposes the film program on the basis that it might someday, somewhere, somehow, cost somebody a job. But when it comes to the film program, it has been demonstrated to have created thousands of jobs and generated hundreds of millions of dollars of benefit for the state of New Mexico. That same defense of maybe one job somewhere, someday, somehow is out the window. And this program is unfairly singled out and attacked in a way that you don't see anywhere else. You don't see any of the opponents of the film program complaining about the hundreds of millions of dollars that flow to the industries in their part of the state and the industries that support them and help to get them elected. It is an incredible double standard, and I'm looking forward to this debate continuing in the upcoming sessions so that we can explain to even more people the great benefits the film program has brought to our state and will continue to bring to New Mexico.
Representative Kintai.
This is the only industry in this state that has its favored status. 25% of all production costs get rebated by the state treasury. This is money that comes away from the taxpayers of the state. This is money that does not go into schools. This is money that does not pay for policemen. This is money that does not pay for paper courts. This is a drain on the public treasury. This is not an asset for the state. The study after study after study by serious economists show this is bad economic policy. Is it good for a few individuals? Absolutely. Do some individuals benefit? Absolutely. Is it popular? You bet. Is it powerful? Yes. Oh, trust me, I know. It is powerful beyond belief. Very powerful. That does not make it right. It's bad public policy. We can't afford it. We're hurting as a state. We have to face up to the reality. This is not good for the citizens of this state.
Thank you. Senator Bemper.
So this is a very healthy debate, and this is putting the issue right front and center as to the importance of the film industry. I would counter some of the remarks by saying, what if we lost that $504 million and the, who knows, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000 jobs? I will tell you that it has taken this industry years to become the gold standard of, as quoted by LA and New York. Get the colleges to start offering animation courses, to get our industry so that we have the best crews in the country. I hear wonderful things about visual effect type training and things of that nature, and I think this is the absolute wrong time to in any way modify or show instability in the most successful program that we have in the state of New Mexico today.
You know, having been in this industry for a number of years in California, it's very interesting that we're coming full circle. The bottom line here is productions are going to go where they need to go. So what are we selling? Are we going to sell off the rate card? You know, if you sell off the rate card, you sell yourselves down the river, then we deserve the reputation that we do have in Los Angeles, which is go to New Mexico, it's easy money. You know, that's not good enough. It's not
easy money.
The other side is there is a fairness issue. You know, there are a number of other industries, and I'm not going to quibble with the fact that we may have 3,000 people working sustained positions. I'm grateful. But what about the other industries that are trying to get a leg up? The 25% credit against expenses, that's what it is. It's a credit against expenses, isn't fair.
Thank you, and I would like to thank the rest of you for joining us today on behalf of the Motion Picture Association of New Mexico and the Rio Grande Foundation. We are having a reception in the lobby, and we invite you participants and the media to stay and continue the discussion with us. Thank you.